Today I want to share our history bit with us. And this particular history bit is going to come from the book of Maccabees. The book of Maccabees. Now, as you know, in about another month and a half or so, we're going to be getting ready to celebrate Hanukkah. And Hanukkah is the celebration of the rededication of the temple. And when we celebrate Hanukkah, we read from the book of Maccabees. Now, in the book of Maccabees that records all of the events that led up to the rededication of the temple, we discover something that is very essential.
Yes.
As it has to do with the alliances that the Judean Israelites had. And our history bit today is going to deal with the Spartans' family tie with the Judean Israelites. Mm-hmm. Did you all know that that great people who are originally called the Lacedaemonians are commonly called Spartans, are Judean or are related, let me say, to the Judean Israelites? In other words, the Spartans are of Israelite heritage. Let us go to 1 Maccabees, chapter 12. I want to read verses 5 through 21. I find this to be an amazing discovery. And the reason why this information is not so widely known in the West, of course, is because the Western Christian Church does not include certain books in the canon of scripture.
Yes.
But when we look at these ancient books, and I'm reading from the Septuagint, which is the book of scripture that was translated from the Hebrew text that was used during the time of our Messiah, they had the book of Maccabees, and they had all of this history. So this information that I am about to read today is something that was already known to the first century Judean Israelites. So let's go to the 12th chapter of 1 Maccabees, and we're going to begin at the 5th verse, and I'm going to read through to verse 21. Beginning at verse 5. And this is the copy of the letters which Jonathan wrote to the Lacedaemonians. Now, in some translations, the word Lacedaemonians may be substituted for the Spartans. Jonathan the high priest and the elders of the nation and the priests and the other people of the Jews to the Lacedaemonians, their brethren, send greetings. There were letters sent in times past unto Onias the high priest from Darius, who reigned then among you, to signify that you are our brethren, as the copy here underwritten doth specify. At which time Onias entreated the ambassador that was sent honorably and received the letters wherein declaration was made of the league and friendship. Therefore, we also, albeit we need none of these things, for that we have the holy books of Scripture in our hands to comfort us, have nevertheless attempted to send to you for the renewing of brotherhood and friendship lest we should become strangers to you altogether. For there is a long time past since you sent unto us. We therefore at all times, without ceasing, both in our feast and other convenient days, do remember you in the sacrifices which we offer and in our prayers, as reason is, and as it becomes us to think upon our brethren. And we are right glad of your honor. As for ourselves, we have had great troubles and wars on every side, for so much as kings that are round about us have fought against us. Howbeit, we would not be troublesome to you, nor to others of our confederates and friends in these wars. For we have help from heaven that succoureth us, so as we are delivered from our enemies, and our enemies are brought underfoot. For this cause we chose Nemanias, the son of Antiochus, and Antipater, the son of Jason, and sent them unto the Romans to renew the amity that we had with them. And the formerly, we commanded them also to go unto you and to salute you and to deliver you our letters concerning the renewing of our brotherhood. Wherefore, now you shall do well to give us an answer thereto. And this is the copy of the letters which Oniaris sent. Arius, king of the Lacedaemonians, to Onias, the high priest, greetings. It is found in writing that the Lacedaemonians and Jews are brethren, and that they are of the stock of Abraham. So here in this text that we just read here, in 1 Maccabees chapter 12, verses 5 through 21, we have a description of a letter that had been referred to, how that the Lacedaemonians or Spartans were brethren of the Judean Israelites. Now, the reason why this letter is mentioned and another letter is being sent was because during this time in history, when the Judean Israelites were fighting against the Seleucid Empire, this is when the Maccabean war was taking place, and they were pushing out the Greek Seleucids out of the land of Judah, they had alliances with both the Romans and with the Spartans. But in this piece that we just read, what is being described is that the relationship that the Spartans had with the Judean Israelites was on a more familial level than with the Romans. They were all confederate together. They had established alliances to fight against the Seleucid Greeks. But in this particular section that we have read, we find that the Spartans are remembered in the prayers at the feast and the sacrifices of the Judean Israelites. Wow. And one of the previous high priests, a righteous high priest named Onias, had been in communication with the king of the Spartans, and they had already made it known that they were of the stock of Abraham. Now, most would never think that the Spartans had an Israelite heritage. But when we read in the scriptures, we're told in Ezekiel that the tribe of Dan was in league traveling with Yavan. That's the name of the father of the Greeks. And it's also another name for the Greek people. It says in Ezekiel that Dan and Yavan were seafarers together. They were in business, traveling the seas of the Mediterranean and doing business and trade. So the tribe of Dan had already left the tribes and began to do commerce with the Greeks and intermingle with the Greeks. And it's believed that the Spartans, the Lacedaemonians, are a people that developed from the tribe of Dan mixing in with the Greeks in that area. And so we find here, based upon Maccabees, that we have Israelites already in Southern Europe. And it's believed that from this line of people, the Spartans, that we have the spread of the Israelite line in Europe. So when we talk about the Israelites being scattered throughout all of the nations, we find real early that there was an Israelite presence, at least we will say descendants of the Israelites, here in Sparta. And the reason why I say descendants is because we know that the Spartans were not a people that were following the ways of the Most High. And if you know anything about the tribe of Dan, the tribe of Dan was the first tribe to go into the way of idolatry. They set up their own little priesthood, had their own priest, their own image. They were basically the first to lead the way for Israel going into idolatry. So we know something about the Spartans. We know that they were paganistic, but we also discover that they were also of Israelite stock. And so it's important that we see this primarily because when we consider the promises by the prophets of the restoration of the whole house of Israel, the prophets have prophesied and they have declared that when the Israelites are scattered, that they will follow the Elohim of other people, but that in the latter times, they would return to Yahuwah and David their king. So we do know that regardless of where the Israelites went, that there would be a restoration and a return. And so we believe that part of that restoration and return occurred by those descendants that are noted here and that also spread in many of the areas of Europe. And I don't have a whole lot of time to go into all of the places where these Israelites went, but for those of us who believe that the tribe of Dan was that tribe that became these people, we believe that it's very, very possible that the peoples up in the Norwegian areas, many of them who refer to themselves as Vikings, who were called the Danes. How many of y'all heard that term before? The Danes is a term that's used to refer to these Vikings. We believe that Dan left his signature wherever he went. So, and of course, there are some who would debate that issue. But the thing that we want to point out is that there was a relationship here based upon Maccabees that the Spartans had with the Judean Israelites. So I hope this information has shed a little light on where the Israelites were, and also that we have Israelites that come in all different shapes, sizes, and colors. Amen.
Amen.
And that's important for us to be mindful of. The Most High has this big rainbow of people.
Yes,
and for those who have issues with the color spectrum, then I want to challenge you to understand that the spectrum goes from the blackest of black to the whitest of white in Israel. So for our non-melanated brothers in Israel that like to keep everything non-melanated, you better get up off of that. Because you've got some black Israelites, because the scriptures also teach about those who will be coming from the boundaries beyond the rivers of Ethiopia. They're going to come. Israelites are going to be scattered to the four corners of the earth.
Yes.
And to my brothers who want to keep everything to the blackest of black, understand, you've got white brothers and sisters in Zion that are scattered all over.
Amen.
So we need to understand that the color issue in Zion is going to have to come to a halt.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Amen. I hope this has been informative to you, and hopefully helpful to you, so that we might be able to grow together
mm-hmm.
in the way of the Most High. His great name be praised.